So our next hands-on building design workshop, Tiny Houses and Tree House, is going to be outside Wilmington, North Carolina, December 2nd, 3rd, 4th. RelaxShacks.com for the details. Hey, what's up? I'm Deke from RelaxShacks.com. We're in Colorado, Colorado Springs, Tiny House Jamboree 2016, hanging with, from the small dwelling company.com, Sam and Lindsay. You guys, I feel, are kind of the underdogs here. I honestly hadn't heard of you guys, your company, before. That's not a diss, but I'm pleasantly surprised at how cool your space is.
Thank you.
A very minimalistic yet modern way.
Thank you.
So tell me a little bit about the build here overall.
Yeah, we took us about 3.5 to 4 months to build it.
It's
2x6 construction with
It's 2x6, yeah.
2x6 construction, okay. With Ecobat insulation. And we didn't get divorced during the whole process. We stayed together.
So that's pretty common, actually. So it's funny you mentioned that. Yeah.
So it was husband and wife. We built it. We wanted to show that anybody could build anything. You know, just you get some tools, and you can do anything you want.
Now I understand this was a driveway build, right?
We built this in our driveway.
Yeah. Because a lot of builders have their fancy, you know, compounds and
we have a driveway.
No overhead.
Yeah.
We have a driveway with a few shade trees that tried to keep us cool in the nice summertime. But
and in Texas, it's especially important.
But we're used to some heat. It doesn't bother us. So.
Now, originally, what's up, Lee? Originally, why did you decide to get into this, to building a tiny house, or get in the game, so to speak?
Right.
Like, what inspired you?
We love the fact that people are able to build their own homes. That is, for me, that is, you know, for as long as humans have been here, we've been building our own homes. And in the past 100 years, we've decided that we can't do it. And we can, and people should. People should build their own homes. Any husband and wife should be able to build their own space and enjoy it.
The simplicity of it.
And for us, it's, you know, the lifestyle of it is amazing. The minimalism, not having a lot of luxury items, not buying into consumerism. We just,
everything you need.
It's all, we just love it. I mean, we love the people.
Well, I wholeheartedly agree. I didn't mean to interrupt, but there's a certain pride in building one's own structure, designing it to suit your own needs, and kind of the bragging rights that go along with that too.
Right.
You know, designing a space and effectively doing so with some cool, clever spatial tricks, which you've managed to do quite successfully.
Thank you. Yeah, where we live in Texas, we've had some people that are tell us that we're crazy. You know, that there's...
Oh, no doubt you are, but I still dig what you're doing.
Yeah, we are. We're not going
to... Well, I like to brag and say I made the cuts for all the lumber.
Yeah, she makes all of our cuts. She's the lady on the saw.
Well, hey, to his credit, we're going to do the video earlier, this interview. He said, I have to wait till Lindsay's here because she helped a lot in this.
Yes.
So you got a good man there.
Yeah, we did it together. She's definitely, I could have done it without her, and she could have done it without me. So we're
all right. So let's move inside. All right, interior here, what are the overall specs? Width, what I see, 12-11's the height?
12-11's the height on the exterior. The inside is about 64 inches wide, and then the length is 20 foot. So it's about 120.
It's 20, really? Okay.
Yeah, 120 square foot. The loft's, you know, about 50 square foot, so.
All right. Now I want to, not before we jump around here, because I want to see the bathroom. People will crucify me if you don't get to the bathroom. It's like people's number one question or favorite thing. So I'm going around and just I'm kind of ad-libbing here as I've seen so many of these tiny houses and picking as I go. I think you guys win the award for the coolest staircase of the houses, 50 or so I've seen. I really like this.
Thank you.
Well, the staircase was Lindsay's idea, and she found something online that she liked. We took a pecan tree that my dad had cut down, and we had a sawmill guy come out and mill the lumber. And then we took it from there, rough cut, you know, lumber, and milled it down, cut it, planed it, sanded it, and we built the countertops out of the pecan and the stair trim out of the pecan.
Well, even better, it has a story behind it.
Right.
You stole the tree from your dad, and now he's ticked.
And you don't see a lot of pecan. You don't see a lot of pecan butcher blocks. I mean,
no, not at all.
Maple's a big deal with butcher blocks, but we want to do something a little different. Bring some Texas pecan in.
There you go.
And then of course we got the storage, the closet.
Yeah.
You know, a little shoe space down there.
We went with leather. We didn't want people catching their clothes.
Yeah, because in a narrow passageway, you know, I'm always like, I got a screen door in my house. I can't tell you how many times my pocket or belt loop hooks in it. I've torn the handle off the door before, so it's one more thing I have to fix.
We went with soft closed drawers and
Yeah, it was hinges. Nice. Yeah.
And it kind of it helped with two problems. It kept you from slamming them, and it, when you travel, they don't slam open and close. They stay closed. That's that was a big deal for us.
I like just the simple, very modern, almost you got this Dwell magazine aesthetic a little bit. The sparse modern, even the dishes here, the open drainage system. Even your window selection, I really like that. Deep sills, so you can use them, they double as shelves. Is this a word a TV nook
that
could be?
That's just for, you know, the you know, your DVR or whatever.
Yeah, oh, okay,
satellite
just, yeah,
cable,
yeah.
Your video games.
Oh, yeah, you had a TV, or I'd walk right by it
if
right there.
If a woman would like to put a plant up there.
There you go. Yeah, I like
if you
that.
Want to sit up there.
Now the TV.
Lindsay's hydroponic garden.
Yeah.
Exactly.
The TV will pivot for the woman in the kitchen.
Mm-hmm. Hey, so, men get in the kitchen too.
Yeah. Yes, that's very true. I'm sorry.
I also like, not to harp on the stairs, I really like this industrial pipe fitting with the flanges.
Mm-hmm.
I've done this in some tree houses too. I love the look.
Yeah.
Sturdy as heck.
It is. It's something I like too. Metal pipe is expensive if you can find it.
We were talking about that. Yeah.
But
it's tough to find it. Free where the threadings, if you don't have to create your own new ones, are still good. The loft, real quick, up here, nice and private. Now, what's the headroom in there? Do you know overall?
I think it is
somewhere like 4.5 feet.
Well, yeah, it's 4'6". You can sit up in the bed and still have a few inches over the top of your head. So.
And then the back of this is an entertainment center.
There's a TV. And
what
we did with the way we wanted to try to circulate some air in here. We put the AC in the main part of the house with a fan to really circulate it. But that right there is a grate, and on the back side of it is an old Vornado fan.
Yeah, those things are beautiful.
And we stayed in it, and we stayed in an RV park that was about 104 to 105 outside. I was worried about the loft staying hot, but with that fan up there and this, you couldn't tell a temperature difference between down here and up there, which was great. There was actually more of a temperature difference between here and the bathroom than there was from here and up there.
That's the methane breaking down the, no, I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm making stuff up as I go along.
It
was all that.
We had a problem, of course. This is our second TV that I've put here, my first TV that we put here. My wife told me, you're going to hit that with a door and break it. And I said, no, I'm not. Don't you worry about that.
Shattered it, yeah.
I blew the TV up. So I've got this up here now. It's just a piece of pipe with a rubber stop on it. You can buy it at any hardware store, and I drilled a hole in it and stuck it on there, and that stops the door from destroying TV number two.
Now the bathroom, let's meander down that way. You narrate, I'm going to walk, and I'll show you the fridge. Is this like a almost three-quarter size fridge here?
It's around 9 cubic feet fridge. It's not too big, not too small, but and then we just went with a small gas oven and stuff.
But it's nice. You got four burners there, so you still can do quite a bit on that.
Lindsay wanted to make sure that it was big enough to put a full-size pan in there.
Yeah.
You know, some of the RV.
To cook that turducken.
Mm-hmm.
You know what that is, right?
Yes, I do. That's what I was like.
I watch the Food Channel. Yeah.
That's so funny.
It's the orgy between a turkey, a chicken, and a duck. The bathroom. Tell us about this. This is a cool shower.
The bathroom, this is what people have really liked. They really like the bathroom. They keep telling me how big my closet is, and that's kind of exciting. But the shower is just galvanized panels, just flat galvanized panels. We siliconed them in place.
Mm-hmm.
We silicone the corners. We bent some trim, drilled a lot of holes to mount everything, and that's. I mean, we just tried to keep it. We tried to keep everything. Our
simple.
Our motto is keep life simple, and that's how we wanted to do this. We wanted to make it where it was just a simple but beautiful. We wanted people to look at it and realize how plain it is, but at the same time, it's got a lot of character.
Did you see the toilet paper holder?
No, where
is it? Under the sink.
Okay, man, you love the pipes, yeah.
I like that.
He's addicted to the pipe.
I don't know.
We have these. We didn't point these out. I love those.
These are like 1950s style vintage push button light switches, and they make awesome.
I
can sit here and do this.
No,
all day.
I like them.
And drive my wife crazy.
Yeah.
And they're UL listed, so they're replicas. They're new, so they work. This is a Panasonic Whisper fan. It moves about 160 CFM. It's got a humidity switch here, so when the humidity gets to a certain level in here because of the shower, it automatically kicks on, or you can just turn it on yourself.
You'd be surprised at how many houses I've seen without any ventilation in a bathroom, which is like such a bad idea.
Yeah, when you come back this way, you can shut the pocket door and see our nice, awesome design. I think I showed it to you yesterday.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to come this way.
It's simple, but I like how it was fun.
It's like the, I could call it the zombie-proof door.
Yeah.
The rivets. Oh, sorry.
British Batten.
Should we lock them in?
Yes.
We really.
The British Batten.
It was fun.
That looks fantastic.
It's just a sheet of, you know, the same metal that's in the shower, you know, with the leftover from the shower, used it for the door. Plenty of space for a cloth, you know, for your clothes, little drawer. We used a full extension drawer slides on everything and soft clothes. We wanted everything.
Oh, this is nice, yeah.
You can't, this is a little place to sit your stuff when you're here, you know, in the bathroom, and it's just a piece of plywood. You can remove it if you don't like it.
Clever, simple,
it's
clever.
It's good for a woman's makeup.
Yeah.
And then we did
but Lindsay, you don't need any makeup.
No.
She's beautiful, just like she is.
Yeah. Lindsay, why don't you tell me about the couch?
So I asked if I could do a project, my own, and he didn't want to put a piece of furniture here because he thought the buyer could put their own piece, which they still can, but I wanted to show it with something. So I built this couch.
I like
and,
it.
It's just simple.
She built it in 3 days in our driveway.
Yes, and it's just
a box with some cushions.
Storage.
It's not too shabby, though. It's actually, you know, you don't need anything more than that. It looks great.
Well, thank you.
Nice and comfy. I really do want to take a nap on this. It's been a long day.
Yes.
Sam, you've gotten quite a bit of sun, I can see.
I was just about to tell him that.
Am I getting red?
Hey, thank you so much for the tour. Again, it's the smalldwellingcompany.com. Sam.
Lindsay. And Lindsay.
You guys are the best. Thank you. I really like this house. It's fantastic.